there, everyone. This is Friendship Bonds 2020 here. Today, I am here for another discussion video. And today, I'm going to be talking about a certain ship from a certain episode that we have seen recently from Thomas and Friends Season 24. And it's the premiere episode, Emily's Best Friend, and how there is a certain ship that I support, but I am going to be explaining this type of ship in greater detail. So, this is the video of why do I ship Edward with Emily. Now, you might be thinking, why do I like this season 24 episode, Emily's Best Friend, and how it stood out for me in the crowd? Well, from a standpoint, the way how I felt about it when I came across that recorded clip before it was released in Australia caught my attention. And it showed me something that caught me completely off guard. Now you know on how I felt about the homage of giving Edward and Emily some interaction together after years of barely interacting to each other. But from a standpoint, I am so glad that they actually got a very nice moment together. Despite Emily just leaving her trucks of sand at the docks just to help Edward. But that doesn't bother me that much because I'm just too into the whole interaction between the two letter E engines. I know that some of you might question me, but I'm actually one of those underrated people who actually ship Edward with Emily. I mean, think about it. I don't ship them just because of their mental behavior, because obviously that doesn't work because Edward is like an old person and Emily is like a young adult, I guess. But I ship them for how they were built at the same time period, just 1 year apart from each other. Like, remember, Edward was built in 1896 and the show doesn't like acknowledge that she was built like a year before Edward. She's like as old as Edward, but the show doesn't acknowledge that, which is, it kind of boggles me. This is something that was very divisive in the episode through its fantasy sequence. Like some people like enjoyed the fantasy sequence, and then there are people who obviously enjoyed it because they're like Edward and Emily shippers. And then there are people who don't care about the fantasy sequence, but it was harmless. And then there are people who, like, pretty much over-exaggerate their hate on fantasy sequences. Even though this fantasy sequence was innocent in a way, I can still understand why they might not like it because of how bizarre it is, but that's just me. And even though the fantasy sequence does show some signs of, like, shipping feel between Edward and Emily, like, the show doesn't acknowledge that Emily is as old as Edward and tends to be a very nice engine at times, while having her own issues of, like, being the boss or something. Like, I can understand why she can be, like a bossy engine at times, because I think seasons 8 through 12 kind of over-exaggerated it, which is, it's like her going a little bit too far with being bossy. I think in the CGI series, they pretty much pulled it off in a more smoother kind of way. But that's beside the point. I'm not saying that I dislike other ships with Emily, like Thomas x Emily and James x Emily. But I'm gonna go briefly on why I don't support these ships, because I think they're like really overrated in the fandom. And how this ship about Edward and Emily is so underrated. First off, shipping Thomas with Emily is kind of off to me. I mean, a tank engine shipped with a tender engine? Just because their mental behaviors are, like, almost similar to each other? Like I said before, I don't ship engines who has, like, similar mental behaviors. I ship engines who, like fit a certain, like, category, like how they can help the other to, like, improve in sort of way. And then there are parts where I can ship characters who are like, well, Edward and Emily, for instance, they were built around like the same time, which is that's a way of how I ship them together, but I'll get into like extended details about it. Okay, back to Thomas and Emily. Briefly, I don't see the two getting together as like a romantic pairing like most people think about it, but I just see Emily being like a big sister to Thomas, and I found it more sensible. When I think about this ship, it's like the Sonic X Amy pairing, and it gets overrated in my opinion. I mean, how many pictures I've seen on DeviantArt about Thomas and Emily being together, and so many fanfics? And I'm like, too much, so overrated. It just feels like the Son Amy of Thomas, even though Emily doesn't act like Amy at times, because shipping the main character with a greater girl character, it feels kind of like shallow at best, because I've seen a lot of this before, and this is like no different. So I just don't think that this ship works, because I just don't think that this ship works. But if you like this pairing, don't take my reasonings to heart and like what you like. I just find this ship pretty overrated, and I'll get into greater detail when I get to the topic of explaining why I think this ship is overrated, but that's basically my summary on it. Then there's James X Emily, which is, it can work, but I consider this ship as for like jokes and laughs. I mean, check out Sammy Clark's shorts, mostly in the James episodes, where James tries to get together with Emily, with Emily denying it every time, or being like weird, like being like confused as all heck. Like, I just really like how James just tries to like get together with Emily, even though she is like denying it like politely as possible. But in a way, sure, they are beautiful engines, but from my eyes, I see them as like just friends, or James is trying way too hard to impress Emily to be his girl through joke videos. It could work, but I use this excuse for laughs. So here is the real reason why I ship Emily with Edward. From my perspective and my good friend Monster Steams' perspective, we see the two having a very rocky start. I mean, if you look at this picture in his Thomas and Friends Sodor Monsterverse universe, here's a complete depiction of how their relationship went, like ever since like Emily's introduction and then all the way up to right now. This is like a perfect depiction of their relationship throughout the series. I mean, back in 2004, they usually like have a grudge against each other, which is, it makes sense. And that's why the two like barely interacted with each other in the early CGI series and in seasons 8 through 12, which is it's pretty understandable. Because Emily feels indignant towards him, which kind of does like sort of make sense, because she was in her bossy state back in the Miller era, which is, in Monster Scene's perspective, I bet Edward wouldn't handle it in a way in his Miller style. And then throughout the CGI series, they started to get in good terms with each other, which is yeah. Despite the lack of interaction during the arc seasons until like up to this point. So yeah, from my standpoint, when it comes to Thomas shippings, even though I'm not a shipper in general, I think Edward X Emily is a ship that is so underrated for mixed reasons, and how Emily's best friend is like a divisive episode for showing signs of shipping the two. Like, I can tell that this episode is, like, mixed at best. Like, some people think it's pretty good. Like there are, like, a few flaws that might have, like, kind of triggered it to not be a great one. Like, they like the episode. They just don't think it's, like, amazing by any means. And then there are people who think it's just straight up meh. Like, they think that this is a plot that it's already tried to go over and over whenever it comes to, like, Emily episodes. But I certainly, like, used to, like, recyclable plots. So there are people out there who might think that this episode is meh at best. And then there are those rare occurrences where people say that it's amazing by any means. But I think it's through their point of view of how they think they like the episode. Maybe it's because it's like... Maybe it's because of the obvious reason of putting in Edward and Henry in there in the episode. And inserting some signs of Edward and Emily shipping. And I can certainly see why on how they like the episode so much. And then there's the other side where some people consider it to be a bad episode, where it feels like a Sharon Miller episode. And I can understand why, because, well, Emily is just searching for a best friend, which is, like I said in my review, it is pretty cliched. But the moments in the episode didn't make up for the cliche premise, which is in my eyes, it's pretty well done. But it still boggles me on how the plot is just pretty cliched at best. But from a standpoint, in general, this episode is pretty much, like, mixed at best. And this ship is also mixed within the episode. I mean, the fantasy sequence is pretty much, well... pretty much a mixed reception between, like the ones who like the fantasy sequence and to others who, like, adore it because it has their favorite ship or they just liked it to have this ship be a thing. And then there are the people who just don't care for it or they just think that it's being totally weird shipping Edward with Emily. Which is, I can understand, but this is my channel, which means I can decide whether Edward needs love or not. Because I think Edward needs the love that he deserves. Even though Emily's best friend is like a divisive episode and how the fantasy sequence does show signs, despite it being a divisive part as well, we have our opinions, which is I can understand. Like my opinion is I do think that Edward X Emily is like a totally underrated ship that kinda needs more love in my eyes because Edward needs love in his life. I mean, I'm not demanding anyone to like it, but it's through your perspective on how you feel about the ship. It's just that I just feel like it just needs some more love and recognition. So I hope that you would enjoy this little discussion I have on this underrated pairing. I hope that you would understand where I am coming from when it comes to shipping Edward with Emily.